Hey, it's Eric here, and today I'll be showing you a little bit about the 3D vessel utility inside mech-q. You can also do 2D in this as well. We've also got mech-q available for both AutoCAD and what's called AviCAD, or AutoCAD Like standalone. So to get started, we can just click on the vessel utility here. And this dialog correlates with this dialog. We'll be getting into this in just a bit. We want the vertical, then we want 3D turned on, nozzles turned on, and then we're gonna choose a flat top and bottom here. And then we're gonna come over here and select for our D distance, which is our width, we're gonna go with 12 feet. Then on the L distance, our height, we're going to go with 13. And then our W1 distance, which is the bottom plate here, we're going to go with 160. So that looks all okay. Let's go ahead and choose draw. Put a point anywhere in our drawing here. We'll choose rectangular for the base. Then we'll zoom up and we'll go into 3D. And there you can see our tank or our vessel. Let's go ahead and shade this. And then we're gonna create a nozzle on the side here. Let's go back into the vessel utility again. We're gonna add a new nozzle. Here, there's a couple things to look at. This is a picture of a horizontal vessel, but if you turn this up on its side, actually it'd be turned up this way. This is the height of the nozzle. This is how far the nozzle protrudes past the vessel. mech-q has calced this for us here. It's an inch past, so if we wanted to go a little bit further, we could go with, let's say 74. And then this 35 is the height. So if we wanted to go, let's say halfway or 5 feet, we would type that in. And then for the nozzle size, we could select, let's say 8. And then we choose okay. And then we choose the draw button again. So let's put this one right here. Let's go with a round base on this one. So we'll select D for round. Now we're looking at the opposite side, so we could go in our northeast isometric to see it. And if we zoom down here, you can see that there. It probably needs to come out a little bit further, but I think you get the idea. If we wanted to change that, we could go back into the nozzle utility and then we could just delete this one, add a new nozzle, and then make this go, let's say, to 83. This one go with 5 feet again. And let's put it right over here. And as you can see, it's protruded out a little bit further. Let's go into a better view of it here. And let's just put a pipe on that real quick. We'll choose the flange here. And we'll go ahead and choose this one here. We'll snap there, point to the upstream direction. And then we'll put a straight piece on the end of that. And we'll just come out, let's say 10 feet and turn it and go 10 feet this way. So there you have it. I got videos on how to use the 3D piping utility. It's at cadavenue.com/basics. So have a look at that. But I just wanted to show you really today how to do vessels. And just let me know if you have any questions. Feel free to like and subscribe, and we'll see you in the next video.